The spirit of our Corps, embodied in the Eagle, Globe, and Anchor, lives within the soul of every Marine. This spirit is born through arduous rite of passage at boot camp and officer training, after which a young man or woman is called a United States Marine for the first time. Our ethos has been shaped by ordinary men and women, patriots who showed extraordinary leadership and courage, both physical and moral.
From 1942 to 1949, approximately 20,000 African-American men enlisted in the Marine Corps at a time when our nation was at war and the country and military services were resistant to integration. They came from the North and from the South, from all walks of life. They came for different reasons. Some wanted the challenge of being a Marine, some wanted to earn a living, but all came to protect and serve their country honorably. They arrived on a rugged and heavily wooded 5.5-acre site near Jacksonville, North Carolina, called Montford Point. The first group of these pioneering Marines built the now famous camp of wooden huts. Others that followed fell in on their handiwork. They braved a variety of threats, everything from the swagger sticks of tough drill instructors to the snakes and the mosquitoes, and even those bears that inhabited the land. In many cases, they were challenged harder than their white counterparts, entering the Corps at the same time.
These brave Marines served with honor during a critical period in our nation's history, fighting in some of the bloodiest struggles in the Pacific, Saipan, Iwo Jima, and Okinawa. Some died in these epic island battles. Many others continued their service in the colds of Korea and the jungles of Vietnam. Many Montford Point veterans, men like Gilbert Hashmark Johnson, Edgar Huff, and Frederick C. Branch, are now legends in the rich history of the Marine Corps.
In June of 1942, I saw a newspaper article to the effect that the Marine Corps had begun accepting Negroes for service with the Corps.
Well, you know, you can't think of being Marine without thinking about the Montford Pointers, because they are the beginning. You often question yourself, could I have done that? Could I have had the perseverance to come and to join an organization, first that didn't want you, two, that had the history of being the last service to do to integration?
The Marine Corps, basically, in the early days, were looking for the best black men that they could find. Four corners of the country. We had men coming in who had their degrees. Some had both their degrees and had a couple of years in vocation. We called them the mighty platoon.
We knew we were being trained harder. And of course, the DIs would tell us that they're going to make us superior to all of the other of white Marines, particularly. In fact, as a matter of fact, we were breaking every record that they ever had because they pushed us to the end of our endurance to where we just couldn't go any further.
You think about where they came and why they came. Many of them were doing just fine where they are. Some were educators, some were professional ball players, some even owned their own business. Some were farmers, and some were just working in factories. But they came because they felt in their heart of hearts that our nation needed their support, needed them to be a part of what was good about America. And a lot of them felt that when they came, when they provided their contributions, that somehow that they would convince the world as well as America that they had earned the right to all of the rights and privileges there are of being Americans.
I went in late enough and we had all white officers, but we had black drill instructors.
Hashmark Johnson was much older than we were. He had spent about three tours in the Army, and he came and he had about two tours in the Navy, and that's how he got to be called Hashmark. He got to service here, earned service stripes. So he had about three of them, I think.
Hashmark was a very strong disciplinarian. In contrast, Huff was about twice the size of Hashmark, and Huff was a big guy. And whereas Hashmark would issue stern disciplinary kinds of orders, Huff would walk up to you softly and knock you on the deck if you didn't comply.
I left home to join the Marine Corps, And when I joined the Marine Corps, when I got to Montford Point, I had 25 cents in my pocket. That's all I had. And the last suit, I had it on, and I came to the Marine Corps to stay.
Huff was strictly, wasn't on the DI, he was a tough guy, tall, big, and strong. And so when he spoke to you, you moved. You didn't dare say anything, because, you know, like I said, you were his mercy. As I said, they could do anything they wanted to do, and they did.
The Marine Corps today is much better than it was for the minority. I see sergeants, majors, I see generals, colonels. When I got out of the Marine Corps, it was only one lieutenant.
Remember when they came in, there was no black officers at all. Matter of fact, when Fred Branch in 1945 was the first African-American commissioned, one of the stipulations that he had to come from the Montford Point Marines.
But I always look at the photograph of Fred receiving his second lieutenant commission, the big smile on his face and his lovely lady beside him. I have a pretty good idea what Fred went through, but I have no idea what his personal experiences were. Given the times, I just have to assume that Fred caught hell.
Now we've got generals with 3 stars, so that's a big change. And then myself, when I went as a private, I never had any concept that we'd ever have a black officer, and yet I became one of them.
There's no question. I, especially after I had an opportunity to meet them and become a part of them and be mentored by them, that when you listen to their stories of their struggles and the things that they did, and more particularly the things that they did to overcome adversity, they were all tools that I put in my kit bag. And as I came up, as I matured through the Marine Corps and encountered some of the similar things that they did, but nothing at all close to what they had been through in the 40s, you know, I would remember things that they said, things they did, and use it in to help me. One of the things they taught me was, you know, if you're focused on your mission, if you know what you want to do, nobody can stop you from doing that.
So you want to think that can you step into the footsteps of these giants and the legacy for which they have left you, that you measure up. And so that inspiration is beyond words, because of what they have done as a part of that fabric of the Creating America history.
And they tell me that they're climbing up on my shoulders, but they did the work. They did the work. And I'm very proud of them.
It's the responsibility of the Marine Corps to anchor the story of Montford Point in the annals of the Marine Corps' rich history. Every Marine, from private to general, should know the history of the Montford Point Marines, who crossed the threshold to fight not only the enemy they were to know overseas, but that of racism and segregation in their very own country. Collectively, they paved the way for the many thousands of Marines of various backgrounds, men and women alike, who serve our nation today with honor, courage, and commitment.